Bring Back Rock.
It's Dean, and welcome to Bring Back Rock. Today, we are talking about a band who has their roots in one of the genre's most loved and respected bands. This is a listener suggestion. They thought everybody knows the debut, but didn't maybe know what happened to them afterwards. So, I'll tell you a little bit about the history, play some music samples, and I'll catch up with you at the end of the video. This is Britny Fox.
Britny Fox formed in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, first capital of the United States, home of Independence Hall, the Liberty Bell, and of course, Rocky Balboa. They formed in 1985. Now, we can't talk about Britny Fox without first talking about Cinderella. No, not that one. This one. Cinderella was formed by guitarist Michael Kelly Smith and Tom Kiefer. Michael Kelly Smith brought in drummer Tony Destra, and both Tom Kiefer and Michael knew bassist Eric Brittingham. While forming Cinderella, MKS, Michael Kelly Smith, heard Kiss may be looking for a replacement for Ace Frehley. He tracked down Kiss's management and got a press kit to Gene Simmons, including a photo and tape. Gene was impressed and called MKS to let him know if they have auditions, he will give him a call. A short time later, Michael received a second call from Gene Simmons, saying that we're writing with a guitarist named Vinnie Vincent and that we're going to give him a shot in the band. This comes into play later, because when Cinderella had a demo, Michael had a contact. He called Gene Simmons back to see if he could send him Cinderella's demo. Gene, always looking for talent, accepted and loved the band. They went to his place and he gave them tips, opinions, and help where he saw room for improvement from his perspective. He also told them he was going to talk to PolyGram Records about them. Around the same time, Bon Jovi was recording in Philly, and would see the band playing in a club nearby. John Bon Jovi was also impressed with the band, and went to his label, also PolyGram, to talk to them about them. With Gene and John in their ear, it didn't take long for Cinderella to get a record deal at PolyGram. With a caveat, PolyGram wanted a new guitar player and new drummer, putting Tom and Eric in a tough spot. But they did accept the deal, so founding members Tony Destra and Michael Kelly Smith were out in the cold and looking to start over. In the meantime, the drummer for World War III, Dean Davidson, had decided to quit drumming and become a singer and guitarist. People weren't taking him too seriously around the scene, since everyone knew him as a drummer. But, with nothing to lose, MKS met with Dean, who came over to play him what he was working on, playing riffs and songs that made the first album, like Girl School and Long Way to Love. MKS called up Tony Destra and said Dean is for real. So the original lineup of Britny Fox was started, with Dizzy Dean Davidson on guitar and vocals, Michael Kelly Smith on guitar, Tony Destra on drums, and Billy Childs on bass. Britny Fox recorded and released a demo with this lineup in 1986 called In America. In February 1987, Tony Destra died in an auto accident. The band recorded a second demo in 1987 with Tangier drummer at the time, Adam Ferraioli, F-E-R-R-A-I-O-L-I. Now, Adam was temporarily the drummer for about 6 months. During this time, they had gained label interest and a showcase was set up. Michael Kelly Smith called up and asked Tom Kiefer if they could open for them to play to a large crowd and a good venue for the showcase. Tom gladly agreed, and Britny Fox opened up for Cinderella for 2 shows in New Jersey as their showcase. Before the second show, they were offered a record deal, but the label wanted a new drummer. Johnny D was playing with Wasted and turned down the gig after Tony died, but with a contract in hand, he agreed to leave Wasted, currently touring in Europe, to join Britny Fox. This was the lineup on the first 2 albums. Dizzy Dean Davidson on guitar and vocals, Michael Kelly Smith on lead guitar, Johnny D on drums, and Billy Childs on bass. Their self-titled debut was released on Columbia in 1988. The album sold well, scoring MTV hits for Girl School, Long Way to Love, and Save the Week. The album went gold, selling 500,000 copies. They also did touring with bands like Warrant, Joan Jett, Poison, and Lita Ford. They also won Metal Edge's Reader's Poll for Best New Band. Now, the only knock on the band was their similarity to Cinderella, but as Michael Kelly Smith says, how could there not be comparisons when half of the original Cinderella formed Britney Fox and Dean's vocals are so similar to Tom's? It's also mentioned by fans that Britney Fox continued more in the original Cinderella sound as Cinderella started to go down a bluesier path. Britney Fox's second album, Boys in Heat, was released on December 17, 1989. A tour of Europe happened, opening for Alice Cooper, and Great White was added on later dates. A tour opening for Kiss was going to be waiting for them in the U.S. for the Hot in the Shade tour. However, the tour got delayed, and when it did start up, Britney Fox was off the ticket, and the Red Hot Slaughter was the new opener. Losing the Kiss tour was a great disappointment to the band, and issues within the band were starting to come to a head as they started a headlining tour of smaller venues. Tough was the opener and was making their East Coast debut. Tough played one show at the band, but before the second show, Michael Kelly Smith and Dizzy Dean Davidson got in an altercation, and Dean left the band, canceling the tour on April 17th, exactly 4 months after Boys in Heat was released, leaving the band with a six-month tour already booked that they never played. The second album never really had a chance to succeed, which is too bad because it's a really good album with, in my opinion, a really bad album cover. A search for a new singer took a lot of time, so much so that the record label decided to cut the band. They went from a promising band to a band with a deal and no lead singer to a band with a singer and no deal. Tommy Paris was tapped as the new singer, and the band found a new record label in East West. This album featured guest appearances by Zakk Wylde and Poison's Ricky Rocket. Zakk's album with Ozzy was being remixed as Britney Fox was recording. He loved the song Six Guns Loaded and was offered the second solo on the song. Bite Down Hard was released in 1991. A live album called Long Way to Live was released on Spitfire Records in 2001. It was a success. Spitfire offered them the chance to do a new studio album, which they did. They released Springhead Motor Shark on Spitfire in 2003. Not long after the release of Springhead Motor Shark, the band disbanded, although bassist Billy Childs has continued the band with different members. At one point, this other lineup consisted of a guitarist called Tommy Crash. Now, while Tommy was in the band, a re-recording of Britney Fox songs acoustically with Tommy Paris on vocals was recorded but shelved until 2019, when it was released as Tommy Crash and Friends, the Britney Fox Acoustic Sessions. Dean Davidson formed Black Eyed Susan and released an album called Electric Rattlebone in 1991 on Mercury Records. He also released a solo album, Drive My Karma, in 2007. Michael Kelly Smith formed the band Razmanaz and released an album on Paris Records in 2003. He is currently teaching guitar and also busy with animal rescue, including cats, dogs, and horses. Drummer Johnny D has kept busy drumming and played with people like Doro Pesch, Blaze Bailey, Doro Pesch, and he is currently the drummer for Tyketto. And because you know I always like to include her picture, I should mention he also played with Doro Pesch. All right, it's music time. Let's listen to some samples and I'll catch up with you at the end. Whoops, hold the presses. Before we get to the music samples, some new information came out on Britney Fox. Now, I knew that Boys in Heat was originally called Fuel the Fire, but this week, Michael Kelly Smith released what would have been the artwork for Fuel the Fire. The record label wanted a different name and gave them the artwork for Boys in Heat, which nobody likes except for whoever made it. All right. Also, Michael Kelly Smith was hopeful that the original members were going to get together and play some shows in the future, so we'll keep an eye on that. All right. Now it's music time. And I will catch up with you at the end of the video.
All right, so that was Britny Fox. Where can you find them? Well, you can find them on the streaming services, except for Springhead Motor Shark is not on there. There you have to go to the secondary markets. The first two albums were re-released on Rock Candy Records. You can find them there. And the Springhead Motor Shark and the live album, the prices are kind of all over the place, but you can probably expect to pay a little bit for those. I want to thank everybody who takes the time to watch these videos and spends time on the channel. If you haven't hit that subscribe button, please do. I really appreciate it, and we will catch up with you on the next episode. Thanks again.